Why? Because we have been so lazy. We hide ourselves twice a week behind closed doors on Sunday morning, Wednesday night, but there are so many dead people around. This is a cemetery. There are so many dead people around that think they're okay. But when you become saved, you know that they are not okay.
Amen.
Because you cannot be okay without God. You cannot be okay without God. It is impossible for you to be okay without God. Just like you feed yourself in the morning, you drink. That is for your flesh. You need to feed yourself with the Word of God. You need to eat spiritually. Because in the Gospel of John chapter 6, verse 53, Jesus says, "Truly, truly I say unto you, except you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you." What is he talking about? He's talking about the Word.
Amen.
If you don't eat the Word, you don't drink the Word, you have no life.
Amen.
Oh yes, physically you feel okay, but spiritually you are not connected to God. That's the bottom line. What a beautiful day. We thank you, Lord.
Amen.
It is time to worship you. It is time to thank you for this day, because it is a blessing to be here. I know my brother was quoting from the Gospel of Matthew chapter 18, verse 20, where two or three come together in his name, he will be present.
Amen.
That I know. We know that you are listening, Father. We know that you are listening. But Lord, we have no power. We have absolutely nothing. Oh yes. All power belongs to you, because you are the omnipotent God. You are the omnipresent God. You are the omniscient God. You are the almighty God. Without you, Father, we cannot do anything. We come today in the name of Jesus, preaching your word. We are asking you to give us the power and the ability to speak on your behalf. May your name be praised forever and ever.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
It will be.
What a beautiful day. See, we are here because of the love of God. Because Jesus loves you. Over 2,000 years ago, Jesus was preaching to the children of Israel. They wanted to kill him. Why? Because he was speaking the truth. Some people cannot take the truth. When they hear the truth, they have what you call itching ears. But Jesus came as the Savior of the world. Jesus came to save. This is the perfect love of God. He didn't have to come down here. Because we broke the law. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. We deserve to go to hell. But Jesus took upon himself the form of a human being and came down here to save the world. All you need to do is to surrender your life to Jesus. That's all you need to do. Lord Jesus, tomorrow is not promised to me. Today is the only one I have. Please help me to examine my life. Help me to step back and reassess my life before I die, because I do not want to go without you. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to do. Today is your day. Again, let me repeat myself again. Today is still the day of salvation. Let me tell you something. The blood of Jesus is as powerful as ever. You know why? Because in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8, the Word of God says, the Lord Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today. forever.
Man.
Because his blood is still so powerful today to save sinners. If you feel like you are not at peace with God, it is possible. If you are not at peace with God, all you need to do is to surrender your life to Jesus. You know why? Because there is no peace, no love without Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus is the Prince of Peace, and the Lord Jesus Christ is the perfect lover. Before you engage into a relationship with anyone, you need to go to Jesus, because the Lord Jesus Christ is the perfect teacher. If you want to be at peace with your fellow man, all you need to do, spend time with Jesus. This is your GPS right here. There are 66 books in here. This is the book of life. Hello? This is the book of life. This is the perfect justice of God. This book is the everlasting wisdom of the Almighty God. I know some people say, oh, that's not the word of God. That's the word of man. Why? Because they are so deep into sin, they don't want to hear the truth.
Amen.
Because when they hear the truth, they will be uncomfortable, because sin is so sweet. Oh yes, sin is so sweet. But God says the wages of sin is death. God is not talking about physical death right now. He is also talking about the second death. Believe me, you do not want to experience the second death. You do not want to be away from God forever and ever while you are into the lake of fire. That you don't want. Everything that you need to know before you die. In 100 years, everyone here will be history. Hello? In 100 years, everyone that you see here will be history. The question is, where will you be forever? Where will you be forever? Is it with the Lord Jesus Christ? Or into the lake of fire? Oh yes. Those who are mocking Jesus 2,000 years ago, what do you think they are right now? They are in hell. They are in hell. They are crying and begging for forgiveness. Jesus is laughing at them. You see, when you have power, don't mess with your power. Because power belongs to God. You have power to do good. Oh yes, they didn't have no respect for God. The Lord Jesus Christ came as the everlasting God. They treated him like trash. Oh yes. Jesus is so meek, so humble. They could not think that Jesus was God in the flesh. Because that is one of the facets of God. God is so humble. God came down, he emptied himself of his glory and came down here to save sinners. But mankind is so arrogant, he is so puffed up. Because when you see people, you don't know people, you give them respect. Even when you know them, you should give them respect. That doesn't exist anymore in this world. Hello? Because love is respect. You don't have to keep on telling me that you love me. Give me some respect. That is enough for me. We have no respect for God. We turn everything upside down. The world is so wicked today. That is the reason why God destroyed the world in the days of Noah. Because mankind had become exceedingly wicked. Oh yes. God says, I'm going to turn everything upside down. God told Noah, Noah, I want you to go and preach the word. The Bible says Noah was a perfect preacher. The man was loaded with the Spirit of God. The man preached the word of God. Nobody believed. Only his children, his wife, and his sisters-in-law, right? Nobody. Nobody believed until the flood came and destroyed everyone. The same thing will take place again very soon. Because some people don't have what you call spiritual eyes to see. Those who are awake, they see the end of the world. Hello? Those who have spiritual eyes to see, they see fire coming. Because Jesus will turn everything to ashes, including the wicked. If you think I'm lying, read this book. Because everything that you need to know is right here. There are 66 books here. These are the perfect justice of God. These books are the characteristics of the Almighty Jesus.
Amen.
If you want to know the truth, put your smartphone aside. Spend 1 hour a day in this book. Believe me, in 6 months, you will be a different creature. I guarantee you. If you spend time in this book every day, you will know the truth. And the truth will set you free.
Amen.
This is your best friend, not your spouse, not your children, not your savings account. This is your best friend. When you die, all you need to take with you is the Word of God. Because when you die, you will not take anything with you that you should know. But because Jesus says you need to have a savings account, it is written in Matthew chapter 6, verse 19. Jesus says you need to have a savings account in heaven. Because if you don't have a savings account in heaven, where do you think you're going? You're going down. You need to have a savings account in heaven before you die, wise man. Your savings account is the Lord Jesus Christ. Because without Jesus, you will never make it to heaven. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the very essence of everything. There is no other way. He is the only... I didn't know that myself because I was stupid. I didn't know. But when he came to me and gave me the Holy Spirit, oh yes, I came to my senses now. Lord Jesus, what would you want me to do? Where is the way? Oh, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Just follow me. For 36 years, I have been following the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, I know how to behave myself. I know that just because you don't look like me, you are my brother. Hello? Just because I don't look like you, you are my sister. I know that we are all the children of Adam and Eve. But some people don't believe. They don't believe. On the day of judgment, many people will say, Lord Jesus, I did this in your name. I did that in your... Jesus will say to them, I never knew you. Away from me. Go to the left. That's where you belong. Go to the left. Because I gave you ample time to repent. I sent my messenger to you. You didn't listen to him because you didn't like him. You didn't listen to the message. You don't look at the messenger. You listen to the message.
Amen.
The message is perfect. You know why? Because it is the Word of God. It is the Word of God. The Word of God is perfect. It is pure. We were created by the Word. Everything was created by the Word and for the Word. That is the Lord Jesus Christ. Let me tell you something. If you want to fall in love with someone, why don't you go on a date with the Lord Jesus Christ? Why don't you go on a date with the Lord Jesus Christ? I am begging you, beseeching you today to make peace with Jesus. God sent you here today to hear the message. That is why you're here today, because Jesus is the winner. Oh yes, he is the winner. He is not a loser. Today is your day. Today is still the day of salvation, as I said before. Salvation is free. You don't have to pay anything to make peace with God. You don't have to pay anything to become a child of God. You do not want